Africa a few over, I'm just like, yeah, that's cool. So I spent a lot of time setting up Morocco for we're literally going to walk through the process step by step, just look in the back office, customize some data types, and set up content based on a project that I put together. Cool about me. You can find me online on Twitter, DesignKing. I do share code on thestartcode.net, so it's usually Morocco related stuff. So if you're ever interested, you can check that out. What we'll be talking about today, setting up your first site. We're going to walk through 6 steps to getting started. So we're going to start with evaluating your design, setting up your document types, creating custom data types. Then we're going to set up our views and our partial, partials, templates, and macros. And we're going to import design files, and then we're going to create content. So I say here's 6 steps. This is really based on this little project that I put together, just a demo. Sometimes when you're back there and you're setting things up, you're going to find that you have to switch back and forth from, okay, in order to customize this data type, I need some content in here so that I can tell it to select only this particular item in the content tree. So you'll find sometimes that you need to go back and forth between these particular steps. It's totally dependent on what your needs are and how you're going to set things up. So we're going to jump right in to evaluating your design. So in this phase, we want to understand our project requirements, things like, are we using Bootstrap? That's a common one. So we use Bootstrap 3. Are there widgets on the page? Do these have to be reusable or completely interchangeable pretty quickly for the client? Just kind of figure out what your requirements are going to be for when you're building a site in Morocco. We also, in this phase, kind of take into consideration how we're going to set up document types and then laying out templates. So checking out our design. There's some very rough wireframes that we put together. So there's, you can't see my mouse, but header, it's a text string, so we got some rich content. I've kind of broken this all out into just one text page, and you'll see why as we go through it. It's all going to be, everything pretty much has similar properties on it, so we've got the header, rich content, and then we have some boxes down here, which I'm calling widgets, because I have no better name for it. They're an image, and they're rich content. So looking through our design, I've broken it all aside. You can see a document types text page. We're going to set up a content tab for this that has the text string page header on it, and then a rich text editor for the body text, and then we're going to set up a rich text editor for the sidebar, just to give them, if they want to put some content in the sidebar, they can. And we're also going to have a widgets tab broken out, and this is going to be where we customize our widgets that are going to show up on this page. And that's actually where we're going to make our custom data type. We're also going to have a widgets tab. That's going to be where you do your image and your rich content for the actual widget itself. So when you're looking through these different designs, the only thing changing is the amount of Bootstrap columns for your widgets that are on the bottom. So it's really just a simple change of, hey, do I want 2 columns? Do I want 3 columns? Do I want 4 columns? It's very straightforward in a sense where all the properties are all the same. It's just we want a different amount here. And then our last one is, well, same properties essentially, but we're just swapping the layout. So now instead of having our widgets go on the bottom, we're going to have them here in the sidebar. And we can actually do this just by clicking a checkbox for the users to where, hey, default, your widgets are going to show up on the bottom of the page. Click this checkbox if you want to show the sidebar. So that's what we're going to do for this setup. I feel pretty solid if you guys have any questions too. So that was taking a look at our design evaluation. So we've got that text page document type that we're going to set up. It's got body text, which remains the same, and as well as the sidebar. And then we have the interchangeable and reusable widgets, which we are going to create a custom multi-node tree picker for. We're going to change column sizes based just, I just put a drop-down list in there so we can give them different options to swap out what layout they want quickly for interchangeable sizes in the widgets. And then if they want sidebar widgets, it's just going to be a drop-down checkbox. So it's just a, instead of setting up multiple templates and layouts, we're just going to be reusing one text page essentially, just to handle the different views. So jumping into the second step, we're going to set up our document types. This is a fun part, because now we actually get to go in Bravo. So we are going to set up, we're actually going to use the composition style setting of document types and not necessarily the nested content way. Personally, I've always done nested content structure for document types, so using compositions is a little fairly new concept. I've kind of mixed it up in the past, but this one's straightforward composition, so we'll see how it works. We're going to make two folders, a components folder and a compositions folder. So in 7.4, you can actually create folders in document types. We're going to do that. And we're going to create a widget and a widget folder in our components, and then a widgets and a master composition in our compositions folder. And then we'll have text page at home. So those will be our main page actual document types. So document types in Morocco are in the settings section. So I've got literally nothing starting. I just set a blank install of a Morocco. So I'm going to go ahead and create my folders for compositions and then components. So folders. I'm going to set up my master composition first. So the theory behind setting up my master composition is I'm not going to have a template. I'm literally just going to use this as a composition for my other pages that are going to be on the site. Really basic properties are going to be on here that most all pages are going to share. So for example, something like SEO. So we're just going to put an SEO tab on here and put page title tag and meta description on here. So that'll just be some basic things that will apply to the other document types that we set up. Master. Title tag. We don't need any validation on this. You could have it if you want, or you could handle it in your code where if you don't have anything here, you can call back to whatever the home page is using or your page name or page title tag in the description. So that's going to be a text box, text area. And save that. So super simple. Just gives me a composition to use for a master so I can apply it to document types later. The next one is going to be our widget composition. So this is where we're going to have our properties for actually changing the widgets on the text pages. So we're going to call this widgets. And I'm just going to change it. Go and create my components, I actually name document type widget, and so they end up getting the same alias. So we change the alias to widget comp, and then we're going to add a widgets tab. And that's going to have our sidebar option, which is just a checkbox. And we're going to actually put a note on here just for our content editors. They go in there and they see that, hey, default functionality of this displaying on the bottom of the page. So I'm just going to say default at the bottom. checkbox there. That's going to change our layout for us. That part's going to be handling the code. And then our widget columns. That's going to be a drop down, and we'll actually have to configure the drop down and the data type if we get to that in the next step. So for now, I'm just going to have it on here so I can reference it. When I update it later, it'll already be on here, so we'll go back and take it to it. There's also one more property that I add on here, depending on some of our clients are more text heavy. So I give them a little bit more control over things. There's also with responsive design, when you're looking at those widgets in the design evaluation, if they're not the same height and the page hits a breakpoint, it's not going to clear properly. So that's something that you can run into if those boxes aren't the same height. So I just kind of add an extra property in here called widget and height so that you can type in the pixels and actually manually set a height, essentially. In the code, I'll have a fallback if they don't enter anything. And then for those who are more text heavy, they can actually pick their height. Our widgets composition. Then we'll go in, we'll set up our components. So we're going to do a widget, and we don't need any templates for these either. So this is just a new widget, and I will give it an icon just so it looks different in the content tree. And we're going to have a content tab, and that's going to be our image and our body text for those widgets. Image and media picker. And then I need to actually be able to allow widgets to be able to be created under here. So in permissions is where you're going to find this allow child no types. And I'm just going to allow a widget. So that sets up my components and my compositions. And then I'll just set up the two pages. So these two are actually going to have a text page or a template assigned to it because we actually want to see these pages. Text page. And that's going to have a content tab as well. We're going to put that page header on here in the body text and the sidebar too. So page header with a text string. And our body text. So these are going to be our actual properties that are just on our text page document type, but we want to assign compositions here too. So this is where we want to apply the master, so we have those SEO properties. So you'll see over here the SEO tab is now on there, so it's getting those properties assigned from the master composition. And we also want. we'll pretend it's there for now. I have no one that works. Back up. So I've got my text page. We're gonna have the master. I'll save that, make sure those are on there. And then we will set up the homepage. So the homepage is gonna be a document type with a template as well. And this is gonna be the Mover site. Just for demo purposes, I just kind of put together a carousel to put on here, just so there's something to actually look at. So, carousel images. It's going to be a multiple media picker. And then compositions will want master on here as well. I must have clicked something, because now I'm going to apply budget tips.
It's demo time, that's why.
That's how it goes.
Yeah.
Alright, so we'll pretend it's there for now. We can look at one that's actually working here. So we've got our text page set up, home page set up. So that is the document types. Let's check it out. We actually need to make sure that we have the proper permissions for our home page then. So in permissions, you'll see we have the allow root. So home page, we just want to make it easier for the editors to only have a home page of the root. So allow root helps that out. And then we want to allow the child new types for the text page in that widget folder. So the folder is literally just for organization purposes, so we don't have a whole page in the tree. So go ahead and allow those. Let's see if that. And that should be your document types. So then our next step we're going to look at is creating a custom data type. So we're going to customize the rich text editor and create a user style sheet, and just to give the editor an option for a header style in there, just they have some ability to change styles. And we're also going to create a custom multi-node tree picker for the widget picker, and we are going to add some pre-values to the drop-down list so that there's some options there. Developer section is where the data types are going to be, and this is actually the part where I was talking about. We need to create some content first in order to actually customize the multi-node tree picker, since we're going to tell it specifically it's only allowed to use certain nodes. So in content, since I've already created my structure, I'm going to go ahead and create a home page really quick and the widgets folder. So that way I just have something empty here to actually customize. So now we have the content. We'll go back to the developer and the data types. We're going to create a new data type. So create new data type. I'm going to call it widget picker. And the property editor, this is going to be the multi-node tree picker. And so we're just going to customize this ever so slightly. It's going to be a content picker. That's essentially what we want. The widgets are going to live in a folder in the content tree. Going to choose the area that we show. So we're just going to only show the widgets folder, and we're only going to allow the document type of widgets. There's some other options on here too for customizing. It's always something you can go in and play around with to see. I typically use the show edit button. It does say this is in preview, but I haven't actually had any problems with it yet. So that's our multi-node tree picker. And then we also wanted to add some pre-values to that drop-down list, just so they have the different options for changing the column sizes for the widgets. I'm just gonna add those. Really simple. Just give them those few options. So now I actually have the widget picker created, so all I've got to do is just add that back to the widget document type. So that was in the composition. And so when we go in the add editor in, I think, pickers maybe? Pickers. So pickers would have widget picker now. So that's our custom data type that we set up. And that is the data types. We'll actually save checking out the rich text editor until we get our files in there. That way we can go ahead and set up that style too. So our next step is setting up our templates, views, and macro. So for our templates, we've already got the home and text page in there because Robin created them when we created our doc types. So we're just going to create a master, and we're actually going to assign that as the master template for those templates. And then we're going to add two partial views and set up a macro with some. And the full carousel is just for demo purposes, so I have something on the home page that's not completely blank. So we're going to go back to templates. So in settings, templates, so our home text page are there. We just need our master. And these are broken out essentially. It kind of goes back to your theory of code and how coding and how to break it out. So the master is what has the header and footer on it, and main things that are going to be on every page of your site, whatever's inheriting from the master. So that's why we have the master. And then we're going to have the text page and home page inherit from that. So they have nothing on them right now, but in the next step, we're just going to import all the code that's already been done, and then it should all work, essentially. So we'll go and assign the master template. So now we have our templates. Really easy. Partial views, we'll go ahead and create those here. So navigation we need for our navigation, and then our full carousel. So usually when we're going through and setting up these kind of things, we'll create everything in a Rocker first and then work from Visual Studio after that, because it's just so much easier to work with all these files in Visual Studio instead. Our last thing that we need is the macros. So the macros are actually in the developer section, and we are going to create a widgets macro. We're going to leave create macro checked. That way it actually creates the macro that we need in here. And we're just going to set up some parameters for it. So essentially the user is given those options for checking the sidebar and the min height and things like that, but we're going to pass some parameters in the code on the template in order to have some fallbacks in case they don't actually check anything. So that's what these parameters are going to do for us. So we're going to set up sidebar. And I'm going to share the code afterwards as well, so if you guys want to check it out and see how it's actually working, or if we have time to look at it. Because we need these values for the code in order that to work properly, that's why we're setting those up. So that's everything that we need for the macro. So our next step is importing all the design files. So essentially this step is developers do your work, because this is where you go in and actually do all the coding, but we don't have a whole ton of time to actually check out that piece in detail, so I'm just going to copy and paste. into the folder from the files that I have. So we're going to bring over, the CSS folder, scripts, and views that have already been set up. Things would essentially be working if I had my composition checked. So that is the file portion of everything. So now we put a user style sheet in here. What we do for that is setting up a user style sheet for the content editor so they can go in here and have different styles to use on the rich text editor. So when you're creating those properties, it's really simple. You just right-click and create, and then you can name it. Personal preference is to break it out into a user style sheet, just to handle, since we work in Visual Studio a lot, to handle any sort of overwriting issues you might have if you have people working in a Braco and other people aren't. So I'm going to create a header style for them to use. So now I've got that property available to this user style sheet. But I just got to tell the rich text editor to actually use it. So that's really easy to do. It's just in data types on the rich text editor. And here you can customize different options for the toolbar. So maybe you want to give people more options here, take some away. It really depends. You can strip it down and make it into what the simple yet editor used to be. It's completely dependent on what you need. And we're going to assign the user style sheet. So now our rich text editor will have some styles in it. I think the last piece was to add some media, and then we can create our content. So, since I already know, well, you guys may have seen the 7 version, I know they're going to talk about 4.7.4. It's much handier in the media section. So it's really easy to create folders and things like that. You can multi-select images, so content images, folder, and then drag and drop things in here. I'm actually just going to go ahead and open the project that is working instead of put everything in here. So just that way, my job types are going to set up. So the only difference between here is that that document type was actually checked, and I have media and content, but we'll still check out. We were in the content section. It's literally drag and drop, so everything's in here, really simple. Just have folders. So all the content's in there. And then our last one was create your content. Yay! So, content section. So in here, I've already gone and set up these widget folders that are in here. Right click create, I've got the widgets because I set up a structure on the doc types. All that's on it is the image and some body text. So they're really simple, and depending on what your needs are for widgets, they can be completely customized depending on what you need. You can do color pickers, background images, all sorts of things. It really depends on what you need in your design, but this is super basic, just demo purposes. So there's widgets that all live in this folder. You can actually use a list view on the folder if you wanted to. I don't have very many things in here, so I didn't do a list view. It's just all in the content tree. So when I created my about page, I've got my different tabs in here. There's some content for page header, body text. Really simple. There's not too much going on here. the easier part to swap out different layouts and things like that is now we've just got some checkboxes and the ability to change widget columns pretty quickly just by choosing a different dropdown. So there's not really, there's no need for multiple document types in order to change the layout a lot essentially. It's really just handled in the code to determine on where it views, where it renders depending on what you check. So the about page just has your header, your rich content, and then we have four widgets that are picked from that multi-node tree picker that was set up. And then we have the two columns. So it makes it really simple. If you want to do four columns, you just change it. You have four columns. It's just a pretty quick way of being able to swap those things. If you wanted them all to show on a sidebar, it's literally just check that. And you can take them out, essentially quickly change and add new ones. It's just really a quick way of putting it together. So it just gives you a little more control over the layout. You don't have to change a whole bunch. You can actually expand on this if you create different templates for a text page. So it's really just using a basic bootstrap grid with a 7 columns and a 4 column over here. There's a 1 column offset. You can create more templates that are assigned to the text page, like 8x4 or 4x8, to swap your sidebars, and then users can just check a new template simply in back here. And they still have the options for rendering in the sidebar, multi-columns, and for the widgets. They just have different column sizes for that main content area. Gives you a little flexibility. That's it. There you go. Any questions?
Yeah. Have you had any luck with getting the bullet points, custom bullet point styles in the RGB? Because I was recently trying to do that, and I looked on the forums and it's like hard to do, or it's not.
Yeah.
You can't just do the normal like add a new style thing. So I'm just wondering if you.
There's usually, I think, how I handle it, because sometimes, because we do like split list or change the list style for things, because it's a pain in the butt since it only adds the span to everything, and then it's much harder to click it. You could handle, I mean, there's different ways you could handle it. I kind of cheat. I won't lie, I cheat. I probably would go in there and add the class to the UL. The two clients that I've actually had to explain that to, they were more techy, thank God, so they were okay to do it. But
okay.
I haven't found anything else.
Okay.
It would be nice.
Yeah.
You guys, any other questions? Is anything similar to swapping layouts? Anything? Different way you set it up?
I mean, you can use the grid for that, I think.
The change in the different column sizes, yeah.
Can you just show the view that the image graph
cells? So it's literally the bootstraps image carousel that's on the homepage. What the text page looks like in order to change everything. It's easy to do. But it's just checking, if you have sidebar widgets, it checks that, and it's either, if you do, it's going to display over in that the A side, or if you don't, it's just going to display over here, so it separates them out. That's the way that does. And then you can see in the parameters for the macro, where it forces the min height, the 3 columns, the default. That one is specifically the sidebar, so that one's checked, and then this one. That's how the text feed works. Whole carousel is literally, if they pick images, they can either pick images themselves, or they can pick a folder, and it'll just take all the images in the folder. That was just something.